Nurt fighting with a rebound. The back tap to Booker. Book able to get to that free throw line extended jumper and gets on the scoreboard early here.
But when his mind is concentrated on scoring, he's difficult.
Book, quick trigger, pulls for three and gets it. C's put him in lockdown. Book with a pull-up three behind the screen, connects on his second triple of the night already. Yeah, it's been interesting. They've kind of played the role of facilitator between he and McCollum. Book sets, fires, wide open look, and triggered by that guy.
He's just hot, people. On. And Murphy is the one that's getting those looks based on how the Suns are guarding Zion.
He's played extremely well in the month of March. And Book, that time, little dribble hesitation on the perimeter.
And so I'm wondering when they're going to look at that in regards to making a change.
Book sees an opening and takes full advantage. First bucket of this second quarter, 26 now on the night. Steal. Quick advance pass to Booker out of the right wing. Get to that left hand, spinning baseline.
I mean, the crowd can only say, oh.
Would have rolled it. Better chance to scoop it off the floor. Book turns the corner, fading left of the lane, and cooking class has officially started here at the Smooth. Seven on the shot clock. Back across the floor to Booker. Down to four. Book, sidestep three. High arching. Rainbow connection. Over the outstretched hands of the defender.
You'll get on.
Really?
You'll get on.
No, cowboy boots. Cowboy boots. Camouflage. Stuff like that.
Book throws the defender, Jones, and knifing right to the basket. We will get embarrassed again tonight because of the way this New Orleans team has been playing. Book with a little leaner.
They were overplaying, and I would say the Suns got a ton of open threes. Devin might have had the toughest looks, but he's so hot it doesn't matter.
Gets a screen, raising up, firing, and connecting.
He's going after Grayson. That's what he's doing. And I shouldn't say anything, but, you know.
Willie pleading his case to Zach Zarbot as Book.
He's got 41, man. It's 21 minutes left in this game. Yeah, I've seen you on those commercials. The residuals must be really good.
4 of 11 from the field for Zion.
I thought McCollum did get away with a travel there.
On the drive and kick, Booker all alone in the corner. Make him pay the price, number one. Does play the passing lane so well. They were able to score on turnovers. Book with a beautiful high left hand over the stretched. Sees the double team come. Back to Durant. Tied up. Six on the shot clock. Booker with Daniels defending. Inside left hand finish. Give him a 50 piece.
Devin finally got loose there. Credit him. They've done a good job on Devin here in the second half, as you knew they would try to focus on. But
Daniels extends. Stepping out on Booker. Gets to the left hand. Scoops it up with a right hand. What a beautiful delivery. Right past the second year Aussie. 52 now.
This is a big time move here. I mean, Daniels thought he had the strip. He thought he had him blocked out. And then Zion right there. I just don't know how they think Grayson Allen can push him back.
Nice little pump fake. Side step three there for Kennard. Cunningham. And you will see a lot of this from Detroit and Cade Cunningham. They are above the norm in terms of shots taken from the mid-range and made from the mid-range. Jaren going to the cup and banking it in. Because if you don't have Desmond Bane and John Morant on the floor and some of these other scoring options, you're going to draw a lot of attention. Cunningham hits again.
Continue to get open for those threes as Luke Kennard. Conversely, the Pistons need to see a defender here. Jaren, good block there from behind.
Cunningham waits out the traffic, banks it in, and draws the foul.
Nice decision there, though, by Santi. Could have taken the shot. He said the hot hand was one more pass away as Kay Cunningham.
Jake LaRavia at the scorer's table. Jaden Ivey curls to the edge of the lane. And Cunningham continues his hot shooting. Cunningham.
It's not a huge shot blocking team. And it's turned to Detroit Pistons. And one thing the Grizzlies don't abandon these type shot opportunities like that. Great play run out of the timeout by the Grizzlies to get Jaren deep post position. You get to see is how well can Ivy and Cunningham play together. And do they have to play opposite one another? And Cunningham showing that he is fine playing off of the ball.
Jaren with an open three puts it in. Yeah, the Grizzlies in the first quarter were pretty much one-dimensional. A lot of it three-point shooting. Jaren back down and finish. Going right at Chimezie Metu. And the rebound to Aldama. This is a Pistons team. They give up an average of 54 paint points per game. That's fourth most in the NBA. Jaren, yes. Taking a page from the BC handbook. Fournier boards. Cade Cunningham lines up a triple and rings the bell. Cunningham.
And Cade Cunningham here in this first half, spectacular.
Probing dribble, fadeaway jumper. That's in as well. Under four remaining in the quarter. Jaren spins the half hook around and out. That's the look you want from him. Cunningham going the distance and finishing. They shoot 35%, which is fourth worst in the NBA, but they're lighting it up tonight because of that guy, Cade Cunningham.
The players and the team that the Grizzlies have felt as though they gave them the best opportunities by being on the perimeter, but those shots, those moves, those plays, two baskets, two possessions, 2 4-points in the paint for the Grizzlies.
Cunningham. 23 for Cade Cunningham with 65 games. We worked 74. Are we eligible for anything? Jaren banks it in.
Thank you for my families. Multiple coverages with Cade Cunningham tonight. Nothing has worked. He's continued to get where he wants to on the floor.
Jaren tries for three. Bango.
Taking just a step towards him. A quick pass back to Luke Kennard. Couldn't recover quick enough.
Cunningham, leaner, hits, and is fouled.
Yeah, they've had no answer.
No. Jackson against Metu. Takes him into paint. Scoops and scores. Jaren with a big third quarter working.
So that the swing can be there.
Metu 5 for 5 from the floor. Jaren again attacking and finishing.
The biggest issue is to continue to try to get this the field goal percentage for the Pistons down is, again, Jaren.
Wow, going to work. 18-point quarter for Jaren. Cunningham, shot clock down to 3. Fournier forced inside the arc. Cunningham a 3 to beat the shot clock. Put it in. Money shot by Cade Cunningham. 3 consecutive 30-point games. 34 for him.
Much of a show that Jaren Jackson Jr. is putting on. Cade Cunningham doing the same for the Pistons.
8 straight by Detroit. Jaren going to the cup. 36 for Jaren Jackson Jr. Grizzlies a 2-point lead and the leather. 2.5 remaining.
How about that extension by Jaren on that block?
Second block. And a finish by Jaren.
I'm watching the antics of CJ. Good fun. And TJ's over doing the entire move that Neesmith had.
And his Team USA teammate from the summer, Halliburton, got it.
Good basketball. Really good basketball.
I mean, recognition early by Nembhard in the air. The ball coming through. Defense is solid. Watch Nembhard gets it, and right away he knows he can move it to the wide open Halliburton. Knocks down that three.
Siakam. Halliburton sets again for another three. Got it. 13 straight Pacers points.
Called the timeout.
Regained that 3-point shot. He got it from Siakam early on, 3.5 minutes in. 13-4. Schroeder off the Claxton screen. And that ball knocked away. Good defense by Siakam.
Oh, yeah. I mean, last minute. Just prior to taking the thinking he was going to take a shot, able to get it. Nice job. He reads it. In that fast break, you see Miles does the right thing. You can learn that as part of the Dallas Mavericks, and Rick Carlisle had great confidence in him.
Here's Halliburton off the glass. Count it. He has a chance for a 3-point play. And just like that,
Watford didn't get a clean look. Keep it going.
Here's Halliburton, another three and another basket.
Yeah, he's had a heat check here to get a hand on it. Read it, wide open. In rhythm, bucket by Halliburton.
He has 14 first quarter points. The rebound tip to Halliburton. Oh,
Siakam has him. What a pass. What an assist. I mean, he throws the ball with only Siakam.
Tipped out by Turner to Halliburton. And yeah. Halliburton pounds it down. Yeah. Yak, yak.
Way to find yourself in position to push the ball back the other way. Halliburton takes a look. Little ball fake. Nobody stops him. Impressive.
We are back, and the Pacers have it again on a missed shot. Here's Siakam, and Halliburton lays it in.
Oh, he was going to dunk it at first and did a nice.
In Chicago on Friday, he made 7 from 3-point range. Brooklyn, a season high 25, and dunking it home is Smith.
And Halliburton gets another assist. I mean, just a nice job. Turning the corner, you see that the defense does not stop Halliburton. Might call a timeout. This is what I think he's going to let him work out a little bit.
Halliburton for 3, perfect.
Yeah, listen, he could have painted the 3-point line out there.
And these teams, what's interesting, they play again on Wednesday night in Brooklyn. Nesmith in the corner from Halliburton for 3.
With a great find.
5 of those games, he's been in double figures. And here's the steal. Halliburton pounds it down.
Anticipation. Coming off kind of a run and jump action. North Carolina used to do it. They would be normally a switch with the good hands. You see them enjoying it.
He's not even standing up yet. No coach. Oh, Clifford is standing up. In that half court. Out of the coaching box, by the way.
It's Tatum on Williams. What do you think?
Chopping him up, dicing him up. At Oklahoma City, he just played like sparing minutes. But now he's getting a chance to actually come out here and hoop.
Came over in the Gordon Hayward trade. Tatum with a hand in the face, drops it in. Maybe a little subjective there.
Oh, so what can I ask? And how they knocks down the 3?
As he calls it, non-shooters making tough shots that they're okay giving up.
I just thought we lost our edge, and then something happened, and he said enough is enough already. Jason Tatum goes strong to the basket.
Defended by Trey Mann around the Brissett screen, probing down low. Hauser, no hesitation, count it.
Yeah, I can just tell the way that Charlotte was set up.
0-on-0 matchup. Tatum wins it. Hit ahead for White. Right back to Tatum. The longest give and go in NBA history ends up with a Tatum 3.
He's clearly a good player. How do you find minutes for him with LaMelo Ball?
Maybe runs your second unit.
And you can play him and Ball off the ball.
Jason Tatum, a two-hand stop.
And I got no problem with it. I lived through that as a coach when I was with the Warriors as Tatum goes baseline. Sweet move. People used to roll their eyes at Draymond Green. Oh!
Jason Tatum! Punishing the iron for the second time tonight.
They have all the other positions all shored up.
Tatum tees it up.
It's a 3.
He's feeling it now on a Monday in Charlotte.
That guy?
A great guy. And he pointed out that Miles Bridges this year has played more games than LaMelo Ball has the last 2 years combined.
Oh, wow.
And Tatum just in control of this game from the jump. Sam Hauser on the tip-in.
And that's just great spacing.
Tatum draws 2, skips it. Hauser, 3-pointer. Yes, sir!
And I think that would include Derek White on the dribble handoff. Yes, please give it to me.
Good call, Romo. Leads to a Hauser 3, and he knocks in another. Ended the third with a triple, and he starts the fourth with a triple. Oh, Hauser,
come
turn
on.
And shoot.
Come
give it
on.
To him. A tough one from Sam Hauser in the corner.
Listen, if Grant makes shots, he'll play. He's a wonderful player, and you know, but he's got to be able to make shots.
Hauser, all alone. Probably don't want to leave that guy. Hauser again. Again. Right down the hatch.
Incredible.
Exactly. That's kind of the point Missoula's been making the last week.
Yeah, you got to know what to react to and what not to react to.
5 on the timer. Tatum. Dagger.
A little mini.
Not a lot of good size and length. Game time 11.
Harris
skips it to Wagner for the nice reverse off the glass.
Is what the article said.
I found the article, the original article from Miami, Oklahoma. It spread like wildfire. Franz Wagner, good for three.
Nice.
Good for three. Good to see. 46 to 44, 3:20 left in the quarter. Wagner challenging Ayton, and that was pretty easy for Franz Wagner. With their biggest lead of the game on an 8-2 run. Franz Wagner, screen from Carter. Back to him on the pick and roll. Perfectly executed.
Franz Wagner, here's his read. Watch number two, Ayton, as soon as he steps up, watch Franz. He knows where to get it to. You got two to the basket.
Harris. Wagner. Rupert guards him. Carter back to Franz. Into the body of Ayton. He puts it in.
It's too fast. Right off of Henderson's hands.
Wagner takes the inbounds pass, scores. He's fouled. 3-point chance for Franz Wagner.
That's Jalen Suggs on this curl. Gives it to him. Perfect timing on that.
DeRozan's at 27 or more points in 5 straight games. 11 so far in this one. Bogey. Beauty.
Oh, man.
Short clock here for the Hawks. Bogdanovich looking at Kobe White. He'll drive, gets inside and lays it in.
Well, that was Vucevic's fault. He gave up on the play. Really did a good job of helping.
Off Caitlin's fingertips, recovers. 7 on the shot clock. Bulls trying to pick it up defensively. That's deflected to Bogey. He'll take the long one and nail it. What a three by Bogey. My goodness.
Well, that one was from Georgia. He pulled up from there. I mean, it didn't even touch the rim.
Bruno, quick handoff to Bogey, controls the dribble, throws up the runner off the glass. Hawks shooting it so well. Working off the Bruno screen. Shot clock down to 6. Bogey hits the mid-ranger. Bogey to Murray. Gets around Caruso. Back to Bogey. Change of direction. Ball fake. Laying good.
Right on cue. Right on cue.